Morning, guys. So it is the day after Valentine's Day. I'm currently very cold right now. I have on these layers. I have on a whole sweatsuit, my robe on. I got some leggings underneath, a long t-shirt under this. Because, to believe it or not, it has finally snowed in Houston. It is, I think, 26 degrees out. It could be colder than that. And the city of Houston has turned off the electricity, so it's very cold in my apartment right now. So I woke up around 9:30. It's about to be noon, because I'm bored at this point. So I went back to sleep, and now I'm about to finally, I guess, snack on something because I bought food yesterday, but obviously I can't heat it up or cook it or anything, so that's out of the window. I haven't washed my face because the electricity is out, so I'm about to light a candle and try to do that now. At least brush my teeth because I need to do that. And then probably get like a oatmeal pie or something and then get back into bed. According to the news, they're saying the electricity may not be back on till tomorrow, and it's almost noon. It's freezing. Like, I've been here almost 3 years now, and I've never experienced this in my life. I never even experienced this back in Virginia, because that's where I'm from. So this is crazy, and I'm experiencing this by myself. So let's get this day somewhat started. Hopefully, maybe later on today it'll come back on, hopefully, but they're saying it may not even come on till tomorrow. So yeah, I'll definitely keep y'all updated though. I'll do a little filming in between throughout my day. I have nothing else to do. So I finally ate two oatmeal cakes. And I'm still hungry. So I'll just lay down. I have nothing else to do. I'm bored. I have no electricity and it's 12:35. Let's just say I'm over it already. And it's not gonna come back on probably till they say tomorrow. So, and it's so cold. Like, I'm bundled up in my robe, sweatsuit, undergarments, and a blanket, and I'm still cold. It's just crazy how this has happened here. Like, I left Virginia to move away from the snow, and I'm like, why is it here? Like, so crazy. Meaning our summer is gonna be hot as I don't know what. So this is a crazy thing to go through, but it's life. It happens. Weather's unpredictable, especially here in Houston. So I'll see what I can do while being snowed in. Not exactly for sure how the roads are. I low key want to go to my boyfriend's house because he has power, luckily. So I don't know. I'll probably just end up staying here. So yeah. So yesterday was Valentine's Day. Didn't really go as planned. I wanted to get all dressed up, cute, you know. All that, but it was cold, it was raining, and then later on the rain turned it into sleet. So what we ended up doing, just once I got off at 3, we went to a little Mexican spot that he wanted to go to, and then that was it. So maybe later on in the week we'll do a Valentine's Day redo, because it's gonna be warmer later on during the week, which is crazy. Like,
It's crazy how it could be snowing one day during the week, and then the next few days 70 degrees. Yeah, like this weather is so crazy and unpredictable. So last night, the electricity went out at 2 a.m. because I was still up. I was like, oh, okay, well, it'll probably be back on by the time I wake up. I woke up. No, it's still off, and I'm over it. I want power, I want heat, I want everything. I'm hungry, but I'm not starving, so that's a good thing, because I did go to the store yesterday and got a few pickups, but still, this is not cool. I mean, I have a candle lit right there on my nightstand, but still, I'm over it. Over it, over it. Hi, you guys. So it is 7 o'clock at night. It's been almost 24 hours without electricity. The light is like this at the moment because I'm using my candle as a light. So it's not pitch black in here. But yeah, I just ate some chips. I guess that'll be my dinner because there's no power. I can't use a microwave, stove, or nothing. So yeah. And pretty much I haven't really done anything today. I went out to my car earlier while it was sunny outside to get a phone charger for my phone. And then I turned my heat on so I could feel a little bit of heat since it's been out since this morning. So yeah, I hope and pray it comes back on sometime tomorrow. They're saying by Tuesday, which is tomorrow, that the power for most of us should be back on. From what I read on the news, it's like 2.5 or more million people without power in here in Texas. So this is a statewide thing due to it being absolutely freezing outside. I think tonight's supposed to be like 12 degrees, and then tomorrow is supposed to be even colder, meaning the roads are going to become icy. So I'm going to remain at home, safe and sound. So yeah, I will. I guess I'll see y'all in the morning. I'm probably not gonna do too much. I took already like three naps today because I'm that bored. So I don't know how long I'm gonna stay up. But I will see y'all in the morning. So good morning, you guys. It is Tuesday. It's been more than 24 hours since I had power. My apartment is even colder. It's at 45 degrees right now. They said the power was supposed to be on today, or at least start to come back on today. I don't know. I hope and pray it does come back on today because it's really cold in here. I haven't ate really anything. I had like oatmeal cakes and some Doritos yesterday. So I do have a good amount of snacks that I can eat throughout the day. I haven't really drank any water today, so I'll probably drink some shortly. And that's pretty much it. It's not really anything open. There's a few grocery stores probably open, but I don't need to go because I have enough stuff to get me through. So yeah, I will keep y'all updated. Just know I cannot wait for this to be over so I can go back to my normal life. Hi, you guys. I'm finally out the house. I just placed the order at the Chinese spot that I eat at. I'm like 10 minutes from my house. The roads are not that bad over here, so that's a good thing. Most of the road lights or the traffic lights are working.
A few of them and by my house aren't working, sorry. So yeah, cause I drove by Popeyes, the line was long as hell. I drove by King's, the line was long. KFC, the line was long. And I have to wait an hour to an hour and a half for my Chinese food. So it is what it is at this point. I'm just hungry. A lot of us are hungry out here. So yeah, I can't wait to eat. That's what I'm excited about. But I'm so ready for my power to come back on, because I'm over this. I'm just over it. But yeah, see y'all once I get my food.
Finally got some food, y'all, and I'm eating this right away while it's hot because I'm starving. It's like my first real meal in a day. So I'm about to eat.
So you guys, it is Wednesday. Still no power. My apartment is still cold. It's like at 47 degrees. What I'm trying to do is get a hotel. There's no hotel available for tonight. So I would get a hotel for tomorrow and then up to probably Saturday to be on the safe side, because who knows when the power is going to come back on. At my complex, they said 600,000 have already gotten their power back so far, but it's over a million. I think over two million that still don't have power. So who knows when we're gonna get ours back. So hopefully I can get a hotel today. Yeah. Hi you guys, can you see me? Hi you guys, I'm so excited because the power's back on, but unfortunately the water's not. The water is still off because I guess it's so cold outside that the pipes are frozen. So if the water does not come back on by noon tomorrow, I'm going to my hotel. And hopefully if I stay till like Friday, the water will be back on by then so I can come back. But yes, the power is back and I'm so excited. Well, unfortunately I cannot take a shower. I can't brush my teeth. I can't wash my face or nothing. So yeah. I already cleaned out my fridge because I had to throw everything out. And I sprayed that down once I emptied it out. So yeah, the process. But you know, it is what it is. I'm blessed and thankful to have my power back and my heat back, because child, sleeping in the cold is not it at all. So yeah, my check-in time for tomorrow, if I do end up going to my hotel, is at 3. So yeah, I'm about to start packing just in case I have to go to a hotel for tomorrow night. So see you then. Hi you guys, so I look so busted right now. I can't, I look a hot mess. But the power went out like literally a few minutes ago. So I'm over this. I'm so glad I didn't cancel my hotel, which I'm going tomorrow. Afternoon, I'm going to pack my bag until Saturday probably. So hopefully by then they can have everything situated. The power won't go out again and the water will be back on hopefully by then as well too, because I'm just over this. It's just too much. So yeah, I'm going to pack my bag as soon as I wake up tomorrow morning so I can get out of here. I'm going to take some food that I can heat up, because there's a microwave and a refrigerator in the hotel room. So yeah, so tonight shouldn't be as like cold as it's been in the past since I had the heat and stuff running. So I should be fine tonight. So yeah, and I'm using my phone for more light so y'all can see me. So I swear it's been the struggle, y'all. But honestly, I just want to thank my family and friends for checking up on me. I really appreciate
y'all, especially for my family and friends, for sending me like money so I could get a hotel room and get food, because it's really been the struggle out here in Texas to find food and then to find a hotel with working electricity and water as well. Like, all this, like, morning I woke up at around like 6:30 ish, calling as many hotels as I could, and half of them, like, the phone was ringing off the hook, so they probably didn't even have power. Rude, but anyways. And then the other half, they either had electricity but no water, and then the others were like all like booked up, so I couldn't even get a hotel for like tonight. So I'm thugging it out here. I'm glad I had everything pretty much charged up though. Like, my portable charger is charged up, my phone is charged up, and my laptop is charged up. So I'm gonna be good for tonight. So this has been a long process. So long. And it's so crazy and insane that this is happening in Texas. Like, Texas is just not built for the snow and for the cold weather, honestly. So, but I just want to say again, thank you for everyone who's been reaching out, because being in this situation, especially by yourself, can be lonely, can be frustrating and sad as well. Y'all, imagine if I had a child or children right now, and we didn't have any like power or, you know, water, and struggling to find food. Like, I would be sad. I would actually cry, because I thought about crying, but I was like, you know what, crying is not gonna make anything better. So I've been just staying positive, and I'm gonna get through this. All of us people who live here in Texas is gonna get through this. So I pray and hope by Saturday or Friday that everything is back to normal. So yeah, I will definitely probably see y'all in the morning. I might stay up for a little while, but yeah. So I will see y'all then. Good night. False alarm, people. We got cable. The power is back on. So hopefully this is a sign that it's going to stay on for good. So we will see. I'm gonna watch some TV until I knock out. By the way, I'm still going to a hotel because there's no water. So yeah. I'll see you guys in the morning for real. Good morning, you guys. So it is Thursday. And as you can see, the power is still on. My heater is running and I have the heat on. Because I have the AC on running at night. So that's a good thing. But there's still no power. I can at least now flush the toilet, but there's no water coming out the faucet. So I'm still going to my hotel today. Check-in's at 3:00. So I'm about to lay down for a little while and then get up and start packing. Because I'm at least stay till Saturday until they fix everything. So I want to give y'all guys an update as far as the water. So the water. So earlier this morning, nothing was coming out, but the pressure is still low. So, and there's a boiling water issue till Sunday, so I'm still going to my hotel at this point just to be on the safe side. So I'm about to start packing up for that. I think I'm gonna fit some noodles and drink some tea as well too before I go too. So I'm about to make some noodles, and since I can't obviously use the faucet, well now the pressure is really, really low at this point. So what I'm going to do is use water bottles to put into my bowl. So I'm finally dressed, switched my clothes. So cannot wait to take a shower at the hotel. So I'm pretty much packed up. Got robe, PJs, my makeup, my face wash, and all that. So, I'm pretty much ready for the hotel. So I'm pretty much packed up and ready to go. I have all my bags at the door. And my suitcase, my ring light, and then my bag. So it's time to hit the road. So today's a little cute road trip outfit. I have on a pink sweatsuit, a flight bomber jacket, and some fur boots because it's cold outside. So I'm finally in the car. I'm about to head to the hotel. Hey guys, can you guys see me? It's kind of dark. Okay, there you go, it's a lot better. Okay, so I'm finally getting settled into my hotel room. I just got some food, so I'm about to show y'all what the room looks like. So this is the door. Then you have to your right the microwave. Then this is the coffee area, the drink area. You have your refrigerator. I put some water in there. And then you have right here is the couch, the lamp,
It's a little table area. That's my food right there. And this is like a little desk area. So I'll probably, maybe I'll like edit a video or watch some videos over here on YouTube on my laptop. Here's the TV area where everything's set up for that. Now to your right, you have it's like a mini bathroom. There's two bathrooms. So this is a sink, the smaller sink. And then right here is the toilet. And I like how the toilet is separated from the other bathroom, like separated from the shower. And then this right here is the sliding door to the bathroom. So open this right here. There's a stand-up shower, which I'm about to take a long hot shower at that one as soon as I'm done eating. And then here is the other sink, the main sink. And I love this mirror right here, the towel area, washcloths, towels right here, trash can. And then right here, hi, is a little closet area. So I could hang up my stuff if I wanted to, but I doubt if I do that. An iron, the ironing board, just a little storage area. In the window. And then right here is going to be the bed, which is a king size bed. I love the size. It's perfect. And here is a little nightstand. And then that pretty much wraps it up. So, can you see me? So, yeah, now that I showed y'all that, I'm about to eat, relax, and then take a long hot shower because I haven't showered in days. And I just feel dirty at this point. So yeah, now I'm going to definitely wash my face too, all of that, because I haven't done that in days. So yeah. Hey guys, so I'm done eating, and what I'm about to do before I take a shower and wash my face and all of that, I'm going to spray the room down with some Lysol. Ooh, excuse me. Ew. And then I'm going to use some wipes, these disinfectant wipes, and wipe down the countertops and the shower and the remote control and stuff like that. So let's get to cleaning. This whole situation has really showed me that you can never or should never take anything for granted, you know, because it could be gone within a second, you know, from having a home over or a roof over top of your head, and then suddenly the power and the water goes out. At the same time, it's been so a crazy experience, especially to go through with living alone. So it's a little bit harder as well too, but I got through it. But I took the easier way out a little bit because I'm in a hotel right now. But yeah. I'm just blessed and thankful for the family and friends that have checked up on me during this time, and especially thankful for the family and friends that have helped me, especially to get a hotel room.
my family helped me, so I'm beyond blessed to have them in my life. So yeah, I'm just chilling.
So you guys, I finally washed my face. I have not washed my face in a few days. Since Sunday, actually. Ugh, the ghetto. So yes, I finally washed my face. It was very refreshing. Ugh. Now that I've taken a shower and washed my face and brushed my teeth, I just feel amazing right now. So I'm about to go back to my bed, chill, and watch some YouTube. Morning guys, so it is the next day. My first night in the hotel was pretty good. I washed my face, brushed my teeth and all that, fixed up my hair a little bit, changed my clothes. So now I'm about to go down and get some breakfast because it's complimentary. So yeah. So I'm back and I got me some breakfast, y'all. Got me a bagel, and then I got some eggs, bacon, and sausage. So I'm about to crush this because I'm hungry. So you guys, can y'all see me? Why is it so dark? Okay, that's better. Okay, so I'm at the Target near my hotel. Today's mission, well, the morning mission, is to find water, bottled water. I have a pack already at my house, but I probably need to get another one just in case, because right now Texas is under a boiling water issue, and they're saying the issue will not be over till like Monday. So let's see if I actually find some bottled water. So I just got back in the car from leaving Sam's Club. I ended up finding water, which was really, really good. So they let us get 2 cases. So I ended up getting 2 cases. So mission accomplished. Hey guys, I'm at Target. Guess what? As soon as I walk in, there's water. Yay! So you guys, my mission is done. Well, actually, I think I'm gonna go to Sam's Club to see if they have any some water as well too, just to be on the safe side. But yeah, I'm pretty much done. So I came in here for some water, but you know, when you come in Target, you come in here for one thing and you get more stuff. I got some Clorox bleach and spray as well too. Cause every time I see it, I try to pick it up just to stock up. So I got this sanitizing spray, Clorox, paper towels. Cause I wash my face with paper towels and not washcloths. Shower cap, cause I don't have one. And then some hair ties.
So you guys, finally back home from going to Sam's Club and Target, which was a success. I found water at both places. So now I am about to try to start editing this vlog from a few weeks ago, and then probably if I finish that early, edit another one. So then y'all got some content coming. So I'm definitely excited because I haven't posted in a while since my apartment tour. So I know I should have been consistent, but I haven't really, really been doing too much besides working and going to the gym. So yeah. That's what I'm about to do for a little while.
Hey guys, so I am, what am I doing? Oh, I just took some pictures for my Instagram. Make sure you follow me on Instagram. And I'm about to finish editing this vlog so I can get it up by sometime tonight. And I definitely need to step out and get some food for tonight as well too. So yeah, that's what I'll be doing for a little while. So y'all, I'm at the restart editing my vlog because I tried Final Cut Pro on the trial. I cannot do it. Like, it's taking too long. Like, I'm trying to get to know the program and I can't. It's taking too long. And I'm so used to using iMovie. It's so simple. Like, I don't get what the hype is about Final Cut Pro. So, since it's like, what time is it? It's 6:15. I'm about to go get me some food. And then, once I'm done eating, I'm gonna just start editing. Like, doing the whole redone, because I can't. Like, I would have been done by now if I used iMovie. So yeah, I'm about to change clothes right quick, slip on something. I think I'm gonna put on what I had on earlier, go and get some food, come back and eat, and start editing. So I'm finally back in my room. I'm about to eat, and look what I got, you guys. I'm so excited. I got me some Chick-fil-A. There was so many options. Like, everything is open over here and where my hotel is at. So I was like, I haven't had Chick-fil-A in a minute, so we'll do Chick-fil-A. I got some macaroni cheese, and then I have a 12 count and a sweet tea. If y'all haven't tried their macaroni cheese, it's crack. It may not be, you know, that homemade macaroni cheese that your mama done cook, but child, it's so good. I'm back, you guys. No mama glasses. I know. I need to get a brand new pair of glasses. You don't have to tell me. But so all right, took my makeup off. I washed my face. I took a nice hot shower. Got my PJs on. These are from Target. Let me show y'all. Better view. Y'all see? Okay, I got on. Hold on, let me change. Put on the sign. Oh, hold on. Okay, now you can see. So I have on this two-piece PJ set. It's a cheetah silk set from Target. So I have this on for my PJs for tonight. And since I'm done with that, I'm about to edit for real this time. So let's get to it. Hey guys, so I am done editing. I finished the video. I'm so excited. I finished the thumbnail as well too. So I'm going to post that tomorrow. And I'm finally in bed. And yeah, I'm about to chill for a little while and then watch TV until I fall asleep. So I'll see you guys in the morning. Good morning, you guys. It is the next day. It is checkout day. So I'm about to get my things together and pack up my bags. Checkout is at noon, so I'm probably going to leave here probably around like 10 o'clock ish. So yeah. So you guys, I am all packed up and ready to go. I'm about to go downstairs and get the little thing for all your luggage and stuff, and then I'm gonna load up my stuff and then myself to the car and then check out. So I finally took my first shower at my apartment in God knows how long, almost 2 weeks. So crazy, but that shower was amazing. I never been this excited to ever take a shower. I think I was more excited to take a shower at the hotel, but this is different because it's actually here at my home. So I just want to say I am beyond blessed for my family and friends that have helped me through this winter storm. You know,
it was a struggle to experience something like this, especially by yourself, especially living alone. So I just want to thank y'all. Shout out to y'all, because y'all are the best. And now that I have power and hot water again, things can just go back to normal now. It's Tuesday. I'm off on Tuesdays. And today, we're going to run some errands. I have to go to the gym. I have to go to some grocery stores like H-E-B and Target, because I have to literally rebuy all of my food that I have lost from the winter storm, because my renter insurance does not cover it. So I have to pay out of pocket at this point. But even though I have to pay out of pocket, I'm so blessed to have my family and friends to help me to rebuy my food. So that's what I'm hoping and praying, that I can find all the food that I had in these stores, because now, and now that it's been like almost a week since the storm, most stores should be kind of back to normal, but we'll see. And then where else I have to go? I have to go to Plato's Closet, so I have to do a little bit of errands today. So let's get to it. So my workout outfit / errands outfit for today is going to be the Ivy Park sports bra with the matching biker shorts. This is from from Beyonce's X Adidas collaboration, and this is from the Drip 2 collection that dropped last year.
You guys see me?
What is up with this lighting? Okay. Alright, this is the best that it's gonna be. Okay, so I just got my car from the gym. Whew, that workout was so well needed. I'm basically now I'm trying to like tone up. I'm trying to get my cardio back because it's been a while, and plus I took a break from doing like cardio, so I'm starting to run the treadmill every other day, and then I do the Stepmaster every other day as well too, because they're both cardio. So now that I'm about to leave the gym, I'm about to go to the hair store next door to get some edge control, and then we're going to finally go grocery shopping because it's well needed. Ooh, my face all greasy. Okay, so I'm back in the car. I'm done grocery shopping at H-E-B. So what I'm about to do is go to Target, because H-E-B didn't have some things that Target does have. So I'm about to go to Target right quick. It's 10 minutes away. And then I should be done grocery shopping. And then I should be on my way home after that. Y'all, ladies, don't y'all just hate how this mask just takes away your lip gloss? I need to put some lip gloss on. Where's my lip gloss at? Oh, right here. So, guys, I'm back from running errands. I went to Target and H-E-B. So, I'm getting y'all a little grocery haul of the things that I got from the store while I was out. Got some soft tacos, because me and my boyfriend are doing taco night, so I got some stuff for that. Some waffles, some shrimp, and these two are from Target. I got some Tide. By the way, don't mind the noise in the background, it's my dryer. Potatoes. And these are bomb. These are from H-E-B. Got some salmon. It's also from H-E-B as well too. Taco seasoning. Shredded cheese.
got some veggies. I got some broccoli. I got 2 bags of these. And then string beans. I got 2 bags of these too. Got some sausage to eat for breakfast. Some ground beef. This is the almond milk. This is one of the brands I use for my protein shakes. Got some lettuce. Got some grapes. Got some apples. That'll be the cheese. Some Alfredo sauce. Some vegetable oil. Got some chicken breast, but a thin version, because I don't like too thick of a chicken breast. Some bacon. Then from HEB, I got 2 of these, which is apple juice. I love apple juice besides water. Those are the only 2 things I really drink. And then from Target, I got a wet jet because I have not been able to mop my floors since I moved in here. So I'm definitely going to do that. Hopefully once I take a shower and stuff, I'll be able to start cleaning up. And then, as far as Target, I got some scrub sponges when I clean my dishes. Fabuloso. This is the key thing to use when you're cleaning your bathroom. This is for the toilet. And then I got these Glad plugins, which I absolutely love. This is like my favorite scent, and it's the only scent that I use in my home. It's vanilla. And then I got the new Glad Plus plugins, but this is like the one that lights up. It's brand new. I wanted to try one, so I got one of those for my room. And then I just got some contact solution. And that's pretty much all that I got from the grocery stores. And now I'm about to put it all the way. Oh, almost forgot, y'all. And I almost forgot, I got some bread. And then I just got some eggs. So you guys, now it's time for me to put everything in the refrigerator, the freezer, and in my pantry. I'm gonna show y'all how my refrigerator and freezer looks. So due to the storm, I had to throw out everything. I already cleaned, as soon as I threw everything out, I cleaned it, sprayed it down. So it's like I'm starting fresh, like I just moved in basically. Then my freezer is completely empty as well too. So let's put these groceries in the refrigerator.
More appeal than any man.